Welcome to the spoken tutorial on nested if and ternary operators in Java. By the end of this tutorial, you should be able to explain nested if statements and ternary operators and use them in a Java program. For this tutorial, we are using Ubuntu version 11.10, JDK 1.6 and Eclipse IDE 3.7.0. To follow this tutorial, you should know about the usage of relational and logical operators and if-else control flow statements. If not, for relevant tutorial, please visit our website which is as shown. Nested if statements. An if statement within another if statement is called a nested if statement. Now let us look at the syntax for writing the nested if statement. In this case, if condition 1 is true, then the program checks for condition 2. Condition 2 is given using another if statement. If condition 2 is true, then the program executes statement or block 1. Else, it executes statement or block 2. If condition 1 is false, then the program will not check condition 2. Instead, it will directly jump to its else statement, that is block 3. Now let us try an example to understand that better. We have the Eclipse IDE and the skeleton required for the rest of the code. We have created a class nestedifDemo and added the main method to it. We shall check if a given number is an even number or an odd number. We will also handle negative numbers using nestedif. So inside the main method, type int n equal to minus 5 semicolon. We have created a variable n to store the negative number. Now we shall write the if conditions. Next line type if within brackets n less than 0 open curly brackets press enter system dot out dot println within brackets and double quotes negative number semicolon. We first see if the number is a negative number. If yes, then we will not check for even and odd. If the number is not a negative number, we check for even and odd. Next line, type else, open curly brackets, press enter. Now, if the execution has come to the else part, it means that the number is non-negative. So we check for odd or even inside this else part. Type if within brackets n modulus 2 double equal to 0 open curly brackets press enter system dot out dot println within brackets and double quotes even number then type the else part else open curly brackets press enter type system dot out dot println within brackets and double quotes odd number semicolon. So we make sure that negative numbers are not considered for odd or even check. Now let us see the code in action. Save and run the file. As we can see, we get the output as negative number. Now let us try a positive number. Change n equal to minus 5 to n equal to plus 5. Now save and run the file. As we can see, the output is odd number as expected. Let us try an even number. Change n equal to 5 to n equal to 10. Now save and run the file. As we can see, the output is even number as expected. This process of including an if statement inside another is called nested if. There is no limit to the amount of nesting, but it is a good practice to not go beyond 3 levels of nesting. Now, we shall look at the ternary operator. First, let me clean up the main method. We shall write a program that divides a number by 2. It is a very trivial program, but the issue comes in dividing odd numbers. When 7 is divided by 2, we get 3. But what if we want the result to be rounded off? Which means when 7 is divided by 2, we get 4 and not 3. In simple terms, we need the next number. Let us see how to write such a program. So inside the main method, type int n comma n half semicolon. We will store the number in n and the half number in n half. Next line, type n equal to 5 semicolon. Next line, type if within brackets n modulus 2 double equal to 0, open curly brackets, press enter, type n half equal to n by 2 semicolon. In the else part, type within curly brackets n half equal to within brackets n plus 1 the whole divided by 2 semicolon. We check if the number is even or odd and do the division accordingly. Now let us add a print statement to see the program in action. So type system dot out dot println within brackets n half semicolon. Now save and run the file. As we can see, our objective is met. We get the output as 3 and not 2. But if we notice, all we are doing is setting the value of a variable depending on a condition. There is more syntax than logic in our program. This is when ternary operator makes code simpler. Ternary operator is a conditional operator providing results similar to nested if. It provides a short syntax and is denoted by a question mark. It takes 3 operands at a time. Let us learn about the syntax of ternary operator. The expression is a condition that has to be checked. Operand 1 is the value of the variable. Result if the condition is true. Operand 2 is the value if the condition is false. Now let us use it in our program. First, let us remove the if-else statement. Type n half equal to n modulus 2 double equal to 0 question mark n by 2 colon within brackets n plus 1 the whole divided by 2 semicolon. This statement reads, if n is even, n half is n by 2. Otherwise, it is n plus 1 by 2. Now let us see it in action. Save and run the file. Press Ctrl S and Ctrl F11 keys. As we can see, the output is as expected. This way, ternary operator reduces clutter in the code and improves readability. We have come to the end of this tutorial. In this tutorial, we have learned about nested if statements and ternary operator and usage of nested if statements and ternary operator in a Java program. Now, take an assignment on nested if and ternary operator. Write a Java program for the following. Check whether a number is even and also a multiple of 11 using nested if. Identify the largest number among the two given numbers using ternary operator. To know more about the spoken tutorial project, watch the video available at the following link. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials and gives certificates for those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at spoken-tutorial.org/NMEICT-intro. This script has been contributed by Talent Sprint. This is Arya Ratish from IIT Bombay signing off. Thank you for joining.